I said maintenance points that you guys have to be aware of as far as greasing of the bearings. And again, you'd have to check the O&M for the type and frequency. Inside of here, by the way, is operations manual, just for reference purposes for in here. It's identical to what you've got. If the blower does need to unload, which is an unloading valve, effectively lets the blower run where it's discharging directly into the atmosphere versus into the system. And the reason for that is to allow the motor to effectively come up to speed based on the amount of torque that would be required to overcome the discharge pressure. Let's say if it was discharging into the grid tanks or the directly. So they allow it to vent directly to the atmosphere, or actually discharge directly to the atmosphere. But rather than, if you're doing like a review or maintenance, you know, walking around just checking things out, and this thing unloads, it'll blow your rear out. So it unloads actually into this area right here. That's the reason I wanted to show it to you, so that it doesn't effectively hurt you. Not only unloading, but also from a pressure relief point of view. If the pressure exceeds a certain PSI, the relief valve is going to obviously let. It'll release that pressure. That also relieves in there, and that check valve is in there. So you have three items that you can access through that hatch over there. This jack is used effectively to lift up this door, the hinge door, in order to allow access to the belts so that the belts are not under tension. So you're relieving the tension as it is right now. The weight of the motor is creating that tension. This is used to take the weight off of the motor and onto this jack. You basically put it right here and lift it up here. Right here. That's all. All you really want, or the other side, all you really want to do is take the weight off of that door so that you can access the belts without there being a ton of any tension on it at all. It's a nice little feature. But in here is your pressure relief valve and your check valve and your unloading valve, just to let you know what they look like. Check valve is pretty much the only piece that you guys had to worry about from a maintenance point of view if you ever have to replace that rubber flapper. Hank, I hereby hand you the key.
Hey, what do you know?
It is a church key. Let's get that church key deal going. Let's go toward you. As I started to say earlier, this area is not an area where you're going to be having to maintain very often at all. So the likelihood of you taking that panel off is actually fairly slim. But you can see that it does come off. And what we have in front of us is an air cavity in an area for the pressure relief valve to relieve. Can you get that? That's your pressure relief valve. Pressure exceeds a certain pressure. Right now I can't tell you. It's probably close to 15 PSI. Once you get close to that, it's going to relieve your pressure that's building up in your blower, that the blower is developing. So it's going to relieve in this cavity and come down and come out to vent. But it's not going to blow your ears off. Now, by the same token, there's an unloading valve in here. The unloading valve is set up so that when we start the unit up, the air is going to unload. It's that piece way over there, that silver piece. The air will unload, meaning it vents or is fed directly to atmosphere, this area, and then it comes down, obviously, and vents. Once you develop a certain pressure and over a certain amount of time, that valve will slowly close so that then your air is directed into your outlet, okay? And inside of here are the six bolts I talked to you about with regards to the check valve. It's right over here. Can you see that? So what we have is pressure relief valve, check valve, unloading valve. Also, this is your temperature feed. Should your temperature get up toward that 275 degree mark, this will feed your switch, which will shut it off. We talked about that earlier, but this is where it's taking the temperature from. This right here, I neglected to mention this earlier, I apologize. This is a fan, okay? As you might realize, heat will build up inside of this unit. This fan is attached to the shaft of the blower. When the blower is turning, it's pulling the air out of here, inside of the unit, exhausting it into this cavity. You don't have to worry about it. There's no extra motor, nothing else. It's directly connected to the shaft of the blower. So it runs at the blower speed. Now what we can do, it's going to be kind of loud, but we can start this up with this off so you can see everything in operation. All right? So just hold your ear. Can we?
I'm still waiting on the electrician. He'll be here in a minute.
Oh, okay. So we got time out. Any questions on this? Anybody have any questions on this? No? All right. Go ahead and start it up. Oh, hold on. Yep. Hold on. We don't have any inlet valve, do we?